Hey, Austin. I thought we were here to drink coffee.
Well, we are, Colin, but I was waiting on you, so I played a little bocce ball.
So where exactly is Sump Coffee?
Well, Colin, it's right here.
Welcome to Sump Coffee. Sump's located in new development. They're calling it One City, just a little bit west of Sylvan Park. Sump originated in St. Louis. Been in Nashville for about 4 months, so we're kind of finding our voice, finding our audience.
How'd you get the name Sump Coffee?
That's a good question. When we opened in St. Louis, we wanted something that had a mechanical nexus. I had a motorcycle at the time, something from 76, and whenever we tried to start the engine would sump, so it would spit a little oil out. That's what sump is, that's what it means. Now it's just kind of this monosyllabic way to express coffee.
If the coffee is anything as spectacular as your beer, we're in for a real treat.
I hope so.
I have to say, this place looks super high-tech. What do you guys do differently here?
So what we do is we source current crop coffees. We don't do any blending, so everything's single origin, single estate, or single varietal if we're lucky enough to get it. Then we develop that coffee in a way to present kind of cup clarity. So coffee really is a seed, it's not really a bean at all. And it comes in a little cherry, it's a fruit. It's technically the most complex foodstuff we get. So like wine has 300 or 400 compounds that lead to the flavor and aromatics, whereas coffee has 700 to 800. And so what we're trying to do is highlight that complexity, highlight that seasonality, and just sort of highlight the origins in which these coffees come from.
I think I learned more in this discussion about coffee than I ever have in my entire life.
Yeah, maybe like all in 12 years of school. Yes. Well, you talk about the complexity of the coffee. It looks like you have some complex mechanisms that help you brew it.
We have a Dutch-made espresso machine. We have some slow drippers all the way from Japan. We also have something else that no one else has in the US, actually. It's a batch brewer. It's Swedish. It's called a hipster. We have something called a pour steady. It's basically like a robot that makes the geometry for pouring, and it produces a tremendously consistent cup. So what I have planned for you is I'm gonna take one coffee and we're gonna pull it and express it as an espresso, but with a little bit longer volume. I'm gonna actually let the robot brew the same coffee, same roast, and then we do a slow drip or an iced coffee with that same coffee. So you're gonna get to try that coffee sort of same roast profile, but three different expressions.
There's nothing we love better than when it goes deeper than just the drink.
Call this the first course. So this is the espresso. It's coffee from Costa Rica. This coffee is processed in what they call a natural manner. What you get in this coffee is going to be something that's a little bit more fruit forward, slightly fermenty, kind of suggestion of maybe something boozy, and dark chocolate.
I will say it's extremely smooth. It's just got a lot of flavor,
yeah,
which is awesome.
Espresso is kind of like taking brewed coffee and putting it under a microscope and magnifying it by like powers of 10.
Yeah.
And that's the experience. That's exactly, that's what,
yeah, you're, and that's so cool.
Around what we have is the same coffee, but presented in a different manner, basically as a pour over with the help of the little robot. But hopefully you'll note a little bit more immediate accessibility, softer presentation, so a little bit less magnification of those flavors and notes.
That's definitely different.
Yeah, yeah.
It's softer, definitely, right? A lot lighter and not as like,
yeah, so intense.
Intense.
Like, yeah, punch in the mouth.
But you can still get like the exponential. It's like you just took it down 10 notches.
Yeah, yeah.
And it's like a longer experience. Too,
yeah,
like
a much longer experience, yeah. All right, so this is the last element. Same coffee, prepared as a slow drip. No heat is added to it. So basically this is just an iced coffee, but the way we prepare it, instead of like soaking it immersively and making it as a toddy, we drip it out slowly over time. So it's refined, but those notes you experienced up to this point, you should be able to spot different elements of that. So maybe a little boozy still from that dank and fruity aspect, but more dark chocolate maybe in this presentation.
I definitely taste the dark chocolate.
I think that kind of like that tart in with the ice makes it a lot more,
yeah,
refreshing.
I'm just blown away that you can get three completely different flavors from the same coffee bean.
Yeah, and they're all fantastic and unique in their own way.
Absolutely.
Kind of like this whole coffee shop.
Oh, thanks.
Another 24 hours in the books, and each time we experience something completely unique and different. The axe throwing yesterday was extremely unique and challenging, and something I didn't expect to do here in Nashville. And then when we made our way to Hemingway's,
that's probably gonna be my new hideout from now on. The wings, amazing. The poutine, never had anything like it before, and the drinks were so complex, and it was incredible. And then coming to Sump Coffee, it's just so cool and modern, and Scott taught us so much about coffee.
I can't get over how much talent there is, how much passion there is here in Nashville. And I'm sure there's multiple places out there we haven't seen yet that have some awesome people behind them.
There are so many more stories to be told, and I can't wait to hear them. Watch out for your facial hair.
Whoa! If the coffee is anything as spectacular as your beard, we're in for a real treat.
I hope so.
You also a yoga instructor?
I am not, but this definitely helps in that area.
This is quite relaxing. What a great chapter for another round.
That's right, and who knows where we're headed next.
Subscribe to the Opry YouTube channel to watch new episodes being released each week. Thanks for watching.